this past October with forecasts for high offshore winds. Millions of Californians were left in the dark as the state's three largest electric utilities proactively shut off power to numerous circuits on their grids. These shutoffs were used as a tool to prevent the utility's equipment from igniting wildfires. After, in the past 2 years, some of the most deadly fires in our state's history were ignited by utility infrastructure, including North Bay fires in 2017, Thomas Fire in 2017, and of course the very deadly Camp Fire in 2018. In an effort to stymie utility infrastructure from sparking fires, in July 2018, the California Public Utilities Commission authorized Pacific Gas and Electric and Southern California Edison to utilize power shutoff programs and related protocols already in use in places like San Diego by San Diego Gas and Electric following fires that plagued the area in 2007 and previous years. As a result, we are witnessing an expansion and growth of these power shutoffs when conditions are dry and winds are high, and there's been an enormous expansion, actually. Now coined public safety power shutoffs, these shutoffs create their own challenges as communities and residents are left without power. As we'll learn today, the impacts of the power shutoffs were wide-ranging and created numerous hardships, and numerous schools were closed, residents' food spoiled, the medically vulnerable who rely on electricity to stay alive in many cases had to find ways to maintain their quality of life, and many other impacts. We'll also discuss outages impacting telecommunications, which occurred even in places where the power stayed on, and limited Californians' ability to call 911 and receive emergency notifications, and just plainly, they were unable to communicate and conduct their daily lives. Today's hearing is intended to allow us to learn what happened and what can be done to mitigate all the risks, as well as to inform our policies as to what constitutes protecting public safety. We understand this issue affects many across our state, including those who were warned of the power shutoffs and never experienced the loss of power. This was only one hearing in a continuing effort to protect Californians and no doubt address challenges with the power shutoff specifically, and also this legislature's ability to communicate with the people of California and to understand the extent in which these power outages affected their lives. We have quite a lengthy agenda today. We have over 20 presenters, and we also will have a time for public comment for those of you that are here that wish to be heard. We will have an opportunity to do that at the end of the hearing. We have tried to do our very best to provide some level of geographic diversity in this presentation, to make sure that we understand the means in which everyone was affected by these outages. We also know that there is much more that we need to hear that is not included in this agenda today. So we will continue to work in the coming months to ensure that we get the full picture and we understand the full story.